In this video, we will go through the 10 best goalkeepers on Sorare, and it's of course on a budget, so let's jump right into it. And the first goalkeeper on the list is Ross Laidlaw. Yeah, I just think this goalkeeper is way too cheap, and he is actually one of my favorite goalkeepers under 15 euros. If you go on euros here, we can see he's like 15 euros-ish, and yeah, we can go to his SO5 scores, and he have had a very good start to the season. He have had some very, very tough fixtures against Celtic, St Johnstone, Rangers, and Kilmarnock. But he has delivered. If he can keep on doing this, he will be a very good one to have. His price is very good as well. Yeah, he has pretty good fixtures, upcoming fixtures. I really like them in general. And yeah, I just think he also is nailed for Ross country. He has a contract until 2026, as we love to see. And let's move on to the next one. The next one is Cristian Alvarez. Cristian Alvarez is 37 years old, so he's pretty old. But his price is coming in at 25 euros at the moment and 360 in rare. But when I go to his SO5 scores, we can see his scores here are extremely good. If we go, yeah, this is the start of the season. Like, these scores are for the start of the season, and he has kept 4 out of 4 clean sheets with very good AA. So if he can keep up this form, he will be an extremely good goalkeeper to have. And the manager have talked very highly about him, and he has said that he will be the number one goalkeeper for the 23-24 season. So yeah, he's old, but you have a nail goalkeeper for 1 year, and Real Zaragoza are currently leading in La Liga, and they are playing very well, especially defensively. And that's what you need for a goalkeeper, that he can keep you those clean sheets and help you win those good rewards. Moving on, we have a goalkeeper from the K-League, Kim Kyung-min. And I think like K-League or J-League players are in general so undervalued. Kim Kyung-min is currently coming in at, if we go here, 18 euros. And his SO5 scores are pretty decent, and like I have watched him play some games, and like he's just so good, and like I have no idea why he hasn't played. Like, he got dropped here, but when he has come back, he has been extremely good. And keep in mind, the K-League scores may sometimes be a bit glitchy, but that's just when the games are at the end of a game week. So for example, against Incheon United, he actually did a very good game, but his AA didn't come up here. So yeah, just so you know that. And yeah, I just love him as a goalkeeper in general. I have him. Like, the reason for me bringing up some keepers that I personally have is because I have a lot of knowledge about them, and I have watched them play. Especially his rare price, I believe, is very, very good. But keep in mind, K-League hasn't so many games at the rest of the season. But that's why players like Kim Kyung-min is so cheap. And we can just see like 56.8 average in the last year. So extremely good. And if you want, you can pick up his backup goalkeeper. If Kim Kyung-min gets rested, or if he gets rotated, but I personally believe he will be the starter, and yeah, I really like him in general. Moving on, we have a goalkeeper from Sevilla, and this pick is a bit controversial because Sevilla has been very bad recently, and his name is Marko Dmitrovic, and we can see he is currently at 22 euros. And if we go to his SO5 scores, we can see it doesn't look the best, especially at the start of the season. He haven't played well at all. Sevilla hasn't played well at all. But there is a but, and there is a big but. Sevilla has midweek features. You have more utility out of him. That's what you love as a goalkeeper, that you have many games you can play in. And also, a game against Atletico Madrid got cancelled, so you have another midweek feature. And also, his price are pretty good for a Sevilla side that can, when they are in form, play very well football. And Sevilla has also signed some new players, Sergio Ramos, the right wing from. Luca Bacchio, I think his name is, and also Mourinho from Real Madrid. So I think Sevilla can do better in general. And they have a pretty good group. Arsenal is a very tough fixture, but other than that, they have a pretty good group in Champions League. And if they come third spot, they have a Europa League football, and that's very nice. And they also have a pretty good upcoming fixtures, as you can see, Las Palmas, Elens, Osasuna, Almeria. That's four extremely, extremely good fixtures that I believe Dimitrovic can get something from. And also, Bounou has left for Al Hilal, I believe. So Dimitrovic is 100% nailed, and Ørjan Nyland is the new signed goalkeeper. So that just shows that the manager of Sevilla believes in Dimitrovic, and he will stay as number one, hopefully for a pretty long time. And the next one, talking about controversial, David Martial. And he's like a bit soft spot for me because he saved me this weekend, saved the rare threshold. But he hasn't been good at all. Hibernian hasn't been good at all as well. And he is currently at 9 euros. And yeah, just look at these scores. Like if you go to his last 10 or last 5. Yeah, just look. Last 15 can go to. Yeah. He has kept 2 clean sheets. And yeah, in general, he hasn't played well. The Hibs has played very, very poorly, so a lot of this isn't his fault, but he hasn't been good at all. But one positive is that he played against Aberdeen and did very well. And this was actually the game when the manager wasn't the manager, it was the reserve manager. I think the Hibs will get a new manager, new coach, so that can profit big time for David Martial owners as me. So, especially in rare, this is a very good time to picking up because he hasn't been well at all. So his price are pretty fair. Keep in mind that this is probably going to be David Martial's last season at the Hibs. I'm saying the Hibs because like that's what every Scottish dude calls them. I just hope he can be a nail goalkeeper in the future. And it's a bit of a risk because they have a second goalkeeper named Valokut, I believe his name is. So if David Martial gets an injury or does too many mistakes, he may get dropped. So keep that in mind, but his price are very fair. But especially on David Martial, do your own research. And the next player was a Malaga player, but he got transferred to Sporting Gijon. And he's currently going at about 25 euros. And we can see his SO5 scores. They aren't the best, but he is a very, very good goalkeeper. He can hit you those 100s once in a while and also be pretty consistent. Like last season, Sporting Gijon was pretty good. And I believe if they can find their form, he can keep a lot of clean sheets and do very well. I love picking up players for La Liga second or La Liga because I think La Liga is the Spanish division is the best league to pick up goalkeepers. Like that's my number one tip. If you need good goalkeepers, pick them up from La Liga or La Liga 2. Just please do it because La Liga is a very traditional league and there are a lot of possession but not a lot of goals in general. But for teams like Real Madrid, Barcelona and etc., they score a lot of goals but like for the mid-table teams, in many cases the games Like, it isn't more than 3 goals, and like that's one of the worst things that can happen to a goalkeeper, is if it gets like, if they lose 3-4 nil because their confidence is so low, and also they get like 12 points, as you can see here, for example. And I think this move was actually very good for Ruben Jiménez. He moved from Malaga, which was a very, very bad side, but he did do very well for Malaga. And I had him when he was a goalkeeper at Malaga. I watched him play some games, and I believe he is criminally underrated. And hopefully he can do well in the future. And he's a bit too expensive, I believe. Like, if you can get him for like 22 or 23, I would have been happy. But he has also a long contract, so you can have him for a long time. And the next player is going to be Edgar Badia. Edgar Badia. Like, it's just insane that he is still at the second division. I personally cannot believe it. Like, he's just a so good goalkeeper in general, I personally believe, when I have watched him play. And he's just so consistent, very good AA, as you can see here. And yeah, I don't need to say much, most of you probably know who he is. He has very high L15, and like, these scores are just going to keep on racking up, because he's in the second division in La Liga. So I would definitely recommend you to pick him up. He's like, Elche is probably one of the best teams in La Liga Smart Bank, and he is 100% nailed. And he's just, I believe he's too cheap. Elche hasn't played the best of football, but hopefully they can pick up good form. And get some clean sheets, and he will be a very good one to have. Moving on, we have Jordi Masip, the player from Real Valladolid. And he has currently lost his place. He's about 13 euros, and I think personally this is the perfect time to pick him up. He had a very good start to the season. This start of the season was here, yeah. Pretty good start to the season, you can say. And then he got ill against Alcorcón. And then he got benched. So now people think he is actually not going to be the starter goalkeeper for Real Valladolid. But let me assure you that I personally think he's going to be the number one goalkeeper. It's just a matter of time. And I don't think the player named John has been any good. So I think if you're on a budget, you can get a very, very nice goalkeeper Jordi Masip for a pretty good price. But keep in mind, he may be the second choice now, but I personally believe he will get it back. But do your own research, of course. And moving on, we have João Ricardo from Fortaleza. And he's currently on a very, very low price. And the reason, if you look at these scores, it's pretty bad. But from game week 289 to 395 or 96, I believe, Fortaleza was in a very, very bad place. They played some terrible football. They had a lot of midweeks, but they didn't deliver at all. But they have recently found their form, and João Ricardo has been so unlucky to not keep more clean sheets. I think it's like 2 or 3 times in the last 5 game weeks. They have, the opposite have scored in like the 19th minute, and also giving away a penalty like at the 85 minute or something. And then like, if I think this game, yeah, he should have kept a clean sheet. This game and also this game. So he's like pretty unlucky with like conceding one goal. And like, it doesn't look so good on Sora data and in Sora general. But he's a very good goalkeeper. And the prices are just so cheap in the Brazil division. So I think this is a very, very fair price. And I would recommend you to pick him up. Moving on, we have David Soria. And actually, I have not too much to say. I don't know too much about him, but I have heard many good things about him. And keep in mind, he may leave in the January transfer window because he is too good for Getafe, in my opinion. And just look at these. Yeah, he had a negative decisive. And he had 10 saves. Like, he's just insane. Have very, very good AA. And only coming in at, okay, only it's a bit. But, like, it is pretty fair, I believe. 30 euros for a very good goalkeeper. With a bit of transfer risk. But if you can get a good club, he can do very well for sure. So in general, I really like David Soria as a goalkeeper choice. And thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. And leave it in the comments, who are your favorite goalkeepers and what do you want to see in the future? My name has been Yusalde and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye and take care. Peace.